Because this government has accepted that we need a continuum of sectors that we need to focus attention on. We need to focus on those sectors that are labor absorbing on the one hand, where jobs that are probably absorbing a large number of people can where the focus could be. And then on the other extreme end, both the DTI and ourselves in the Department of Science and Technology have agreed that we need to target certain sectors where we are going to manufacture high-tech component for exports. And of course, there are things in between where we need to use technology to enhance the competitiveness of existing sectors. So I'd like you to remember that there's this continuum that we need to address, first point. The second point is that we need to do this as government because we need to diversify our economy. In my view, I think at the moment we are concentrated on a number of sectors, and especially for exports, where we are finding ourselves in a situation where if you look at our current account, we find that the amount of what we import exceeds what we are exporting. And in fact, I've just recently heard from economists that this creates another perpetual problem that on our current account deficit, there is always about 2 or 3% of our current account deficit that will never go away because we have to pay royalties on the technology that we bring to South Africa. So over a period of time, therefore, this diversification, in my view, is important because it will help us to bridge that current account deficit almost immediately. And therefore, in the diversification, we also need to identify areas where we are going to, in my view, add value to the raw materials that we have. I would like to remind you that if you are involved in high-tech manufacturing, however, it does have a job multiplier effect. I'm just going to quote a couple of jobs multiplier effect. If you are involved in general manufacturing, the job multiplier effect is between 1.58 and 2.5. If you are in the high-tech manufacturing, the multiplier effect is about 3.5. If you are in the microprocessor electronics manufacturing, it goes to about 4.5, and then it goes on and on. So I do think that, again, the conversation which says either or, it's not a useful conversation to have. And therefore, I think as a first, to address the first question, South Africa doesn't have an option, but it has to get involved in the high-tech manufacturing.